People pass by the towering statue outside the Clinton County Courthouse every day. Few people recognize it as David Rice Atchison. Likely fewer understand the plaque below that declares him President of the United States for one day.
But he was this vital, important pre-Civil War person, and he pretty much just vanished off the pages of history.
But on March 4th, 1849, he was the nation's highest-ranking elected official sworn into office. The nation's 11th president, James Polk's term had expired, and the president-elect, Zachary Taylor, refused to be inaugurated on a Sunday. David Rice Atchison of Missouri had just been named president pro tem of the U.S. Senate.
Atchison is also celebrated in Kansas in the city that bears his name at a museum that says it has the world's smallest presidential library.
He's in the 12th position there.
The Atchison County Historical Society Museum's Hall of Presidents puts Atchison between Polk and Taylor and features an 1849 newspaper article that explained how Atchison may have accidentally become president for a day.
In 1849, there was no pressing thing that would happen. Today, if we didn't have a president for 24 hours, the whole world would be in total chaos.
The museum asked visitors to vote in a ballot box from that era what they'd do if they were president for a day. So how did Atchison spend it? After being up for dozens of hours signing final presidential papers from the previous term, mostly sleeping.
His friends started showing up to wake him up, to ask to be appointed as, you know, ministers to different countries or part of his 24-hour cabinet. So people realized this odd thing was happening at that time.
Atchison never gained the official title of vice president either, but would serve in the de facto capacity under two presidents because of deaths in office. He retired from politics shortly after the Kansas City was named for him on the losing side of the debate whether Kansas should be admitted as a slave or free state. A marker next to his grave declares him president for a day, or as he'd often say.
And he had the honestest administration ever in the history of the U.S. He didn't spend any money, didn't declare any wars.
So was Atchison really president for one day? Still up for debate, but the ordeal made sure that it would never happen again. Dave DeMarco, Fox 4 News.